I literally just returned from the grocery store in a snowstorm in order to create today's shoot. So I got myself some oranges and we're gonna get a little crafty with them. Hey friends, welcome back. Today I am going to be taking you on a behind the scenes of a self-portrait session dictated by my Instagram stories. I sent out a few polls on my Instagram stories to get people to vote on color, on texture, on vibe, era inspired, and lighting inspired based on other photographers' work. And yeah, and so what I came up with based on the results that happened was that we have to shoot something orange, we have to shoot with glitter, we have to shoot something like 1970s kind of vibes, and using flash photography. So for the photo shoot itself, I'm probably going to be shooting a lot of it with my Cybershot point-and-shoot camera, as well as my Fujifilm camera, just because it has like a really good on-camera flash. In addition to that, I might use the Canon 5D Mark IV with an external flash as well, just to see the difference that that makes. Now, as far as the styling goes, I don't have a lot of orange clothes. I have a lot of yellow, and I have a lot of, I even have red, but I don't have a lot of orange, and so I had to be creative. And so I think we're going to be sticking with mostly like waist up photos because we're shooting in the basement anyways. When I was kind of putting together the idea for the shoot, what came to me was like a glittery orange. And I know that sounds like what? So what we're going to do is we are going to actually take this orange and I'm going to paint it with Mod Podge and then cover it with glitter. And then for myself as part of that, so we're going to have a full one and then we have some half orange slices as well. So I'm going to cover the rinds in glitter. I don't know. This is just what my brain showed me. So this is what we're doing. This is how photo shoots go. But also I think I'm glad people chose glitter and flash photography because glitter always shows up super awesomely, when you're using flash. So I've got just some regular glitter from, is that gonna work? There we go. No, focus. There we go. From Michael's. And yeah, so I couldn't find orange glitter and it's a snowstorm out today, so I couldn't go buy any orange. So we're gonna use gold glitter on the outside of an orange, hopefully letting the orange peek through here. And then makeup wise, we're gonna be doing an orange look as well. So yeah, let's get into creating some glitter oranges, shall we? Okay, so I'm going to be using Mod Podge to cover the orange here, and then we're going to sprinkle it with glitter, and this is going to make one hell of a mess. I should probably put something down to cover it. So I'm going to go get an old towel to put down so that way my desk isn't a complete mess. So I actually found this box that I got from Tailored Body Jewelry. Don't look at my address. Tailored Body Jewelry, and it's the perfect size for the small space that I'm working in here. So that's what we're going to do. And because the orange is round, I had to figure out like, what am I going to put it in? So that way I can kind of circle it around as it dries. And so I'm using just a regular coffee cup that's used for paint water usually. So yeah, so we're going to just start and Mod Podge. Oh God, it's been a while since I've opened this guy. I think I Mod Podged the lid together. Come on, you bastard. Okay, so if you ever encounter the same thing, just so you know, you just have to run the lid under hot water. It has been a very long time since I have used this. All right. Okay, let's get some going. Here we go. And then I'm just using a regular paintbrush and we're just gonna paint on the outside of this orange. Now, if you have a fake orange, you could do this around like a plastic orange would probably work as well, or a styrofoam orange. I just don't have access to those right now. So, yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to coat it as much as possible, wait for it to get a little tacky, and then we're going to just shower it with glitter. Yeah, and then see how much of it sticks. Because I don't want it, like, I do want it to be pretty well coated, but I also want to make sure that some of the orange still shows through, you know, which is why I like using Mod Podge, because it is clear when it dries, so you don't actually see it. Okay, so that's probably pretty good for the first round. Oh, I also had spray varnish I could have used, or spray stuff I could have used, but we're gonna go. And now for the fun part. Oh, is this even open? Nope. Mm-hmm. Making a mess. And then what I'm gonna do once this side dries is I'll be able to take the orange out and roll it in whatever glitter is left in the box. Okay. I think this is gonna look pretty cool. Kind of excited. I don't know why. Sometimes, you know, when your brain just like shows you something, you're like, okay, let's see what this becomes. This is one of those moments. I just need to grab another paintbrush, I think. So cute. Okay, we're gonna do a bit more on the side here because I can see. Doing this in a box was a great idea. What I'm going to do now is take my little slices, and I'm just going to kind of roll them back and forth after I paint them. Because if I want to do any shots where it's like that, it'll look like I'm eating a glittery orange, which I think is cool. Okay, so we're gonna let that guy sit for a hot sec. I'm gonna be very sticky after this, I can see. Ta-da, ba-ba. Okay, so we're gonna set him on his side right there. Boop, next. Sometimes you just gotta go where the art is asking you to go and see what happens. Is this gonna look like absolute trash? Maybe. But that's what self-portraits are for, is playing around, trying new things, just having fun. Even if it looks like trash and you end up making a mess, which I am. Okay, beep beep. There we go. Oh, this was a good one. Yes. Look at this guy. Okay. I don't know how many of these I'll need. It's more so just for like a set, you know, a prop kind of thing. But we'll do a few and then we'll eat the rest. Oh, I wonder if I had orange. No, I thought maybe I had orange edible glitter. That would have been good, because then I could have actually eaten the glitter. But I don't think I have orange, because orange is not a favorite color of mine, usually. Mustard is, but not orange. Okay, you can settle down there, buddy. Wow. I remember when I first started doing photography, when I was like just learning how to use my camera, and obviously I couldn't afford to buy anything, so I would just like create whatever was in my head, and I miss those days. So that's why self-portraits kind of let me honor that inner creative that's always got a beginner mindset and is like, I don't know, let's see what happens. I think that's a really important part of like, especially if you're running a photography business, is to make time to, whether it's self-portraits or photographing your friends or whatever, just making time to photograph the things that your brain is showing you that are cool, because from there is where you will learn techniques and skills and ideas that you can, build off of for client shoots. Most of the posing or set design or things like that I created in my studio for clients came out of me photographing in my basement and like, oh, how could I create this on a larger scale? And what would it look like with more people involved? But it all usually starts with an idea in your basement, Like most good things, start with an idea in your basement. Why are basements such a good place for ideas? You hear about all the computer people getting their best ideas in basements and whatnot. All right. Ta-da. Okay, we'll do one more. And then that will be it until we turn this little guy around and do his bottom half. Get his bottom sorted. Quite excited, and I'm excited to see what kind of makeup I'm gonna do. As you know, my makeup tutorials are legendary. Or legendary. Okay, we gotta move that guy for a minute to get to the pile of glitter that is hanging out in the bottom of the box. Ah, so good. All right, so that is it for the halves. So we'll let those dry, and we're gonna turn this guy around and get his bottom half done. I don't know what it's gonna be. And then I have to think like 70s for outfits that are orange. I used to have from Hippie and Shake, I used to have this great bodysuit that it was a bit too short to be a bodysuit for me, but I would just turn it into a tie top. And it had a cape on it, and it was in fact orange. Yeah, so I'm sad that I think I gave that away or sold it during a when I was getting rid of the studio. But that would have been perfect. Yeah, but I did just make a tie top that I think it's more mustardy, but with a little Photoshop or Lightroom, you can make things any color that you want. Here we go. Da, 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 da. Coat that friend. Oh, this is so messy. Okay, so then what we'll do once this is dry, because it's still tacky, as you can see, once this is dry, then we'll probably coat it with a varnish or like a sealer, a sealant, so that way it holds it a bit more in place. But we'll wait to do that once it kind of dries a bit more. So that is it for this portion. The next portion is going to be getting on to the makeup. And yeah, and then makeup, wardrobe. I don't know if you can see behind me. No, it's kind of hard to see. There's a jumpsuit that I've pulled out from Lucy and Yak right there. It's kind of like florally, and it's got a cool lapel. It's a like on the burnt orange side, so I think I'm gonna end up wearing that, and then yeah, and then I'll do my makeup with I think I have orange colors. If not, again, I'll do it in as close to orange as I can get, and then I can adjust that once I get it into Lightroom. So yeah, let's get on to the next segment, shall we? Okay, so this is the outfit that we're gonna be wearing for the shoot. I'm not sure if I'll keep the collar up or not, but I'm hot right now, so we're gonna just take it down a bit.
But now it's time to do the makeup. And as you know, that is my favorite part. So we're going to try. I have to go on a Zoom call before I do my photos, but after I record this piece. So I don't want to do it too dramatic, but I mean, heck, it's who I am. So I might as well be a little dramatic. So yeah, I'm going to go grab my makeup stuff and then I'll come back and then we'll get started on the makeup. Okay. So I've decided, I've got this like eyeshadow stick, which looks like it's a kind of the same color. It's probably as orange as I get in terms of like something that's easy to put on. I also grabbed, and I wasn't sure what color this was, but I've used the purple in the past and I really liked it. So from Quo, they have matte liquid eyeshadow. It feels pretty gross going on, if I'm being honest, but I also don't wear makeup a lot, so that might be why. Ah, there we go. So it's like, this one's kind of like a burnty color. I gotta put it in front of my face so it focuses. There we go. So it's kind of like a bit more pink than it is orange. Now the other thing I was thinking was to go in a completely different direction with makeup. Since we're gonna have orange everything else, what if my eyes were a different color? Like my makeup was a totally different, complementary, but different color. So we'll deliberate on that. I'll show you the color that I'm thinking. This is another Quo one, the same. I just like, so it's kind of like a tealy boy. Focus, don't look at me. There we go, I gotta cover up my face. There we go. So it's kind of a tealy boy, which might make for a cool contrast, but I don't know. I think I'm feeling just orange. So we're going to give this guy a go. And then in my palette here, there's some orange. This just, I don't know what company this is. I just got it at the store. Well, I guess most of this comes from a store. And then this is from, I don't even know. These don't even have names. That's how not quality. This looks like an orangey type friend. And this one down here as well is an orangey type friend. But I couldn't find any like bright orange. I guess oranges are more yellow. So, sorry. That's what we're going to do. So we're going to start first by covering our eyelids with concealer again to kind of prime it. I find it just works better because I have like rumplies in my eyelids. So this is a great way for it to kind of like stick to something. So yeah, let's get on with that. I do need a mirror though, or I'm going to use my iPad here. Sometimes this is what I'll use for my thing. I just use the camera. The camera on here. It's a thing. I'm certain I'm not the only one that does this. It works. All right, so we're going to start with this. Oh boy. We're already off to a good start there. Now we don't, again, I don't want it to be too wild. Maybe no pictures this time. Like no drawing graphics or going above the eyebrow line. We kind of just want orangey tones. So we're just putting this down as a kind of a priming situation. I don't know if this is how you do the things. I just feel like by thinking of makeup like painting, then you would put a primer down to make it easier to put a color on top. I don't know. That's just me. But maybe there's a different way, you know? Okay. And I'm just using some random concealer I found again at Winners. It was like cheap, so I was like, that'll work. I don't think it matters what color it is. Like if the concealer matches my skin tone or not, I don't think that's important because I'm just using it as a priming concealer. But you may think differently. Okay, so should we go in first with this guy? Yeah. Let's try it. Okay, maybe we have to wait a minute for that to dry. Okay. No, you know what? We're not good. Well, yeah, okay. We'll just do it. Just going in hot. Oh, she is orange. Nice. Okay. I dig it. This is definitely a good starting pencil for orange. Now my favorite eye, always. I don't know why this right eye gives me the hardest time. I think it's my right eye that gives me the hardest time. Yeah. Wait, yeah, right eye. But that is orange. Okay. Okay, so we've got like kind of a base color. It's a look. I'm not upset about it. Okay, so now we're gonna add, oh, I thought that was orange, but it is, that's kind of orange. Look over there. It's kind of an orangey glitter in here. Maybe we'll do that. Oh, there's some pink at, we'll just add a little bit, just add in a little bit of glitz. Just a little bit of glitz. Oh, come on. Okay. Just get it on the eyeball. You know what? I think we're gonna use our finger for that. Pack it in, as Sandy told me. Pack it in. Just pack it in all day. And I think I'm going to just blend out the orangey bits up top there. Let me get the color out of this brush. He's got a little bit of green. I mean, is that the worst? Maybe. We're just going to brush it up. Smudge it up. Smudge. And then we're going to go in with the dark eyeliner again, because again, this is a 70s style shoot. Now, what I realized in my research of 70s, 60s kind of style makeup is they also have a really like almost neutral or nude lip, or like a soft pink lip, which is interesting. So we're going to go for that as well. Okay, we're getting there. Okay, now I feel let's see, here's my orange. Ooh. She's a bit more yellow than my orange. How do we get that? Maybe I add some yellow into this. Give it a go. Let's see what happens if we put yellow on top of this. Could ruin it all, or do nothing at all. Maybe we put the yellow up top. There we go. Now we're doing something sunsetty. Where do people get like their really bright makeup, like really bright color palettes? Cause that's what if I'm gonna put makeup on, I don't want it to be just like blush, you know? I want it to be extravagant, fun, playful, vibrant. And it's super snowy out today, so I'm quite excited that I'm doing some sunshiny goodness on my eyes. We got hit with a big frickin' snowstorm. When you see this, it probably will have passed and hopefully be nice outside. There we go. I think that's kind of good. Okay, from here, we do have body glitter. So this is from Urban Outfitters, and it is some of the best glitter that I've had. It's Chunky Boy, it's delightful, and I've used it before in past shoots. Like, look. Look at that. Isn't that fun? This way it'll kind of match the orange slices. But we don't want to put it everywhere, just on parts of it. There we go. And maybe around, because it's body glitter. Oh, there's some pink on here. My nephew and I were playing around with makeup on the weekend. There we go. That's looking cutie. This is literally like some of the... Oh, fuck. I didn't mean to get it down there, but oh well. It's glitter. She'll go where she wants to. Glitter's like an independent lady. You can't control her. You can't keep her locked in. She's going to go where she's going to go, and she's going to travel. Maybe that's why I love glitter so much. She'll travel and go where she wants to, whether or not people approve. I think that's why I love glitter. There we go. Kind of want to look like dandruff. Here we go. I think it looks fun. Okay. So from here, I was going to do a dark eyeline because that's like a very 1970s kind of thing. But I don't think I'm going to. But what I am going to do is I'm going to draw the little dark lashes underneath, because that is a very, like, very model-y type thing that they did back in the day. But that I'm going to wait until after my Zoom call. My little interview thing I'm doing. Well, I mean, doesn't matter. You can see me going back and forth. Do I want people to see me with so much makeup on? That's something that this is why I'm challenging myself to play with makeup. Because that's something that I feel very insecure about. Because people are very good at it nowadays, number one. But when I was younger, I had my best friend had this tinted lip gloss. And so I put it on. It was grade 6. It was picture day. So I just kept putting it on all the way around, of course. Nobody told me about it. Nobody told me that I'd like color all around my face like a kid does. And then I got my pictures taken, my school photos taken. And then my mom got them and she got mad at me. So my brain essentially was like, as the good kid, like, you made your mom mad by wearing makeup, so don't wear makeup. So that's why, like, yeah. So I was kind of humiliated. So humiliation feels the same in our brain as physical pain. So naturally, I would stay away from wearing makeup. As well, anytime there was like a movie back in the 90s, like anytime there's a movie where like maybe the chubby girl got a makeover or the ugly girl got a makeover, and that's who I identified with more than the popular character, just because I have brown curly hair and I'm big. Every time she would put makeup on, somebody would make fun of her and be like, oh, look, like, she's trying so hard. So then my brain was like, okay, well, if you're not going to be that, then you need to be the other. You need to go the complete opposite direction. No makeup, no, like, that's not for you. This is the path for you, which is to kind of push away anything that's feminine, including makeup. So this has been kind of my reclamation of, reclaiming makeup for myself as a thing of play and fun and joy and expression, as opposed to having to be perfect at it, as opposed to, being for somebody else other than myself. So, yeah, that's kind of it. So I'm going to leave it here for the moment. I am going to come back, and then we'll do the black and then probably the pastel pink for the lips, which is always a look I'm not a huge fan of, but it is very 1970s. And so if I want to take this in that direction, that's kind of the approach I have to take. Okay, so let's go come back after that. And yeah, it'll be good. And then we get to setting up the set. Okay, so I've got all the things, and now we're going to head downstairs to the basement to do our self-portrait. So we're going to set up the backdrop. I'm still not sure what the backdrop's going to be. Maybe just my orange backdrop. And then we're probably going to, I'm going to try to use the posing table, because I think I want to keep it like chest up, really close in on the face stuff. And we'll go from there and see what it looks like. Okay, so now we have to do the set design. So I've got a few different choices. I've got a green backdrop, which might be kind of nice, complementary. It's kind of a chartreuse kind of green color. I also have an orange backdrop, which would be orange on orange on orange, which is a vibe. Or I have a teal blue, but it might be a bit bright. So, I think I'm leaning towards the green to start with, and then we'll go from there and see how we like it. I also have a kind of an old vinyl shiny brown, which could also work, but we're gonna start with a green and then see how that turns out. Okay, so because my main flash isn't working, we're going to be using this bad boy, which has a little pop-up flash, which we'll see how it works. I may have to come closer to this camera to see what happens, but we're going to give it a try. Now, the problem with this camera is that it does not have an app, so we're just going to have to set the timer and hope for the best. I guess I'll put my batteries away. And then once we're done with this bad boy, then I will use the Cybershot one as well. But that one runs out real quick. Like, let's see what these look like. They're gonna look cool. It's just not the camera that I was expecting on using today. So we'll give this one a shot and just record with that one. All right, so this is my makeshift tripod. Okay. We're taking pictures already. Okay, it's looking a bit dark, so we're gonna adjust, like, the settings on this thing are not super great, but we'll try it. Why is my focus? Okay, we're gonna have a slow shutter speed. Okay, that's a bit too bright there. Okay, let's try this. So we're just testing out the brightness here to see. Okay, so now we're gonna zoom in. Oh man, that digital zoom though. It is, you know what? It is a vibe. And that's what today is all about. Why is my focus there? This thing, I swear to God. No, that's good. Focus. This camera, I'm not 100% certain with. Yeah, 10 seconds, there we go, okay.
Oh, it's going. Oh, damn it. I'm trying to, get my stupid watch off. Okay, well that will be a good first test to see kind of like focal. I look very unhappy, but that's okay. Let me see the focus here. Zoom in. How do we... Oh, Jesus. Guys, this is like new. There we go. Okay, so I'm not very much in the focus, so we gotta figure that out. This is turning out to be way more work than I anticipated. Okay. I was so excited this is gonna be easy. Nope. Some days you don't get a free pass. Okay, we're gonna pop this here. Then we're gonna pop this guy up. Oh, he's barely tall enough. God damn it. Why do I gotta be so tall? Okay, what can we put on top of that? This seems dangerous, but we're gonna give it a go. Totally normal. This is me. Well, actually I'll be more here, I think. Okay, so we don't need this. But we will put that there so I can set my little thing down once we're done. Okay, here we go. We're going to focus on that. And okay, so I've added a brown, it's like an overthrow that I made, just using all the fabric there to try to change it up. What is happening here? Okay, already it looks a bit cooler in the camera here. Let's see, let's zoom in a bit. We're gonna have to move the table over a tickle, I think. Oh. Wise, now that we've got this figured out, we're going to be at f9, shutter speed 15, because I want to kind of blur the sparklies, and ISO 800 because I'm shooting in the basement, and the white balance is not great, but that stuff you can always change later. So we are going to give this a go and hope for the best. Self timer, 10 seconds, here we go. There we go. Okay, we're gonna go for an orange backdrop. We're gonna try that and see if that helps us out at all. Oh, this is harder. This was a harder one than I thought, my friends. Which is good. Challenge is good. We're gonna go change our outfit. We're going to wear, I have a Solstice Intimates bra and panty set that I think maybe will be a bit better for the vibe we're going for today. This was cute and all, but it's gonna be a bitch to get out of, I'll tell you that much. So this is the next outfit that I have that's in fitting with the theme of orange. It's kind of a burnt orange, but while I was over there, I found this sheer orange dress that I have. So we're gonna shoot this a little bit, but I think the sheer orange dress is going to be the winner. And this is the thing about self-portraits, is sometimes you try things and you try things and it gets really frustrating, but it's in the searching of the thing that you find the thing that works. So I'm gonna wear this for some, just do a few photos like this, but I think I'm going to end up wearing that one, and that's going to be the one. So yeah, we'll give this a go and take it from there. Here, we'll see if you can see it in there. Like, it looks a lot more flashy because everything is dark around it. So sometimes that helps to like emphasize the flash. There we go. Okay, we're gonna try something here. Maybe. Will that sit on there? Dang. Oh wait, there's tape in here. So I have this Starburst filter for my Polaroid, and I wanna shoot, see if it will, Starburst my photo. So let's see. We gotta tape it on first, cause it's too small for my lens. But let's give it a go and see what happens. The last outfit, we're going to be doing this lovely orange dress. But the battery on that camera is going to die soon, so you may not get to see this actually happen. But just to give you an idea of the vibe. I can't believe I didn't see this sooner. Anyways, yes, let's get to it. So here we are at the editing portion of the self-portrait shoot, and as you can see, I've loaded the images up and have and I'm just going through them now. So this one looks really fun. So the first set of images here are from my Fujifilm camera, and now the whole key to kind of making photos look filmy is to apply presets or create presets that are literally built on film. So there's a whole swag here. Those ones are dull as hell. I don't want those. Ah, like that looks good. I kind of dig it. Makes it orange poppy. It kind of takes away the green though. So let's go enhance our greens. We want everything to be popping. That is the point of shooting with different, again, you want to think about what kind of film aesthetic was it. And then the other thing is, as you can see here in the curves, it's brought up a bit. You want, oh shit, that's not what we want. Stop that, dirt. You want to move, come on you. Will it let me? There we go. If you bring up kind of like mute the shadows a little bit is what we're kind of going for here.
There we go. Kind of like that. I think we'll be good. But the key or the trick will be, will this work with human photos? So let's go take a look here and apply it. Okay, obviously the cropping needs to change, but aside from that, actually, it's not that bad. It's kind of cute, but it's not, I mean, there is grain, obviously. Maybe it's because the photo's blurred. Like, to me, it's still not filmy. That's a technical term, right? All right, let's apply it here and see. Okay, that's a bit better. I don't know if I like this picture, but right now we're just trying to, like, that. Yeah, that looks filmy, definitely. We could probably stand to add a bit more grain into it. And so sometimes what I'll do is use a photo like this. I don't think I'm going to end up keeping this one, and use it as my test subject. So that way I can kind of narrow in on it. But I like a thicker grain for sure. There, it's popping. Okay, so let's copy this and see. That makes it a bit grittier, which is obviously what we want as well. So here's more fruit photos. Doo-doo. Yeah, like, I don't know, I think that's kind of cool. Let's bring this down a bit. Obviously, every photo we're gonna have to tweak a little bit anyways, but I dig that. Let's keep going. Sorry, there's a bunch of videos that were on this card. Da, 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 da. Okay, let's go. This is the thing, like, it's like cameras are almost too good these days that they make photos look too good. And this is why I love shooting film, because it allows me to make messy photos and not great photos. Maybe we blow out the highlights, bring down the shadows. No. I kind of dig that. That's good. I like that vibe. That's cutie. And orange. Not sure about the 70s, but whatever. Now, ooh, this one might be good because it has the blurry. Like, that's good because it looks like it was caught in a moment. Like, oh, orange on orange. You caught me. You know what I'm talking about. But the softness of it speaks of that era. I could add some dust to this. One of the, or a few of the presets I have are, let's see, we have where is it? Not that. Dust and scratches from Quest. Let's see. They take a bit of time to show up on here, but oh no, they're doing good. Just some of them take time. I mean, that's something maybe I would add later in Photoshop. I think they're pretty fine without it. Also, like if you remember, oh, of course I froze my computer. If you remember past videos, I think I talked about, I also will use the Tezza app to edit my photos sometimes, the ones I'm going to be using online. So I can always add textures through that app as well. Ah, so cute. That's fun. But yeah, I think that literally they're just too clean, these photos. So I'm going to go, these are again the ones from the Fujifilm camera. So let's go look at these contrasted against the ones that were shot on the Cybershot or Cyber, whatever you call it, Cyber point and shoot. Where is it? 2000? No. Maybe this is it in here. Oh yeah, here we go. So these were the ones shot with the Cybershot, Sony Cybershot. So already it looks like much more filmy. And so when we add in, like, yeah, that is way more, like, I can't create that. Unless this is where having like a, if my flash would have been working for my Canon camera, I think it would have worked. But this is the kind of vibe that I was going for. the whole time, and I really just should have shot everything on my Sony Cybershot. Like, it just looks so good. Well, except for that one, obviously. That's when I was trying to put the thing in front of it. But, like, look at the fun little things. I don't know. It's cute. Yes. Ah! Just so good. This is, yeah. You cannot replicate shitty cameras so well when you're shooting with a good camera. So just get yourself a shitty camera and shoot with it, is the point. Yep. Oh, look at those cute little stretch marks, just stretch marking. These are freaking adorable. Like, these are the photos that I wanted. This is the vibe I was going for the whole time. Yep. And I'm just doing a one-click preset off of the thing I created with those other images, the Fuji ones. But ultimately, like, these are so good. So much better. And it's just because they're messier photos. Like, they're just not as good. Just not as good photos. Like, the quality is shittier. But I love it. I look a little evil there, but I don't care. I was trying to juggle my damn orange, okay? And to be fair, the whole orange concept did not go the way I had intended it to. But that's okay. That's the beauty of self-portraits. It's just, like, trying things and seeing what works, what doesn't work, and taking it from there. Oh yeah, there are these which didn't turn out. This one might. So cute. But these look like, to me, like legit flash photos. Like, we were at a party and for some reason I was in my underwear with glittery oranges. Yeah. Yep. The glitter. Oh man, there's glitter literally everywhere in the basement right now. Crop it in. Like, why did we ever create better cameras? Ah, so silly. Okay, let's rotate right. Okay, so you might see some bits coming up here, so just a forewarning on that. Just because this was a sheer situation. So I tried to cover my boobs as much as possible, because obviously I knew I wanted to post these somewhere. But, like, that looks so good. I will always, like, if I can find more cameras like this one, I will shoot with it more often because I love this look. Like, yeah. And this is just a $25 thrift store find. So you can get your own version of this just at your local thrift shop, I'm certain. This one is, again, a Sony Cybershot is what it's called, but any digicam type situation will create this look, and it's so good. Like, I think this is, but there's some nippies, so just, like, avert your eyes, people. Here, we're gonna crop in. There we go. Make it super cutie. That's so cute! Like, come on! How am I this cute? You know? So, when you crop in, obviously there's grain on the crappy photo, like, from the camera, so I don't maybe need as much grain added myself here. Ugh! Like, I can't get over it. It's just too good. It's too good. Yes. So, I think the winner out of the cameras for this particular self-portrait challenge, as dictated by my Instagram followers, the winner is definitely Cybershot for this type of lighting. I really wish my flash would have worked for the Canon camera so I could have seen the contrast between it as well. You know, I'm going to leave that like that, even though it's sideways. I kind of dig it. Yeah. Just to see if I can create this with, like, actual, a good flash. The flash that was on the Fujifilm camera isn't super great. So, it definitely had its limitations as to what, like, how strong it was and all that good stuff. Ooh, I like this one. I like this one. I think one of the key things, too, I'm noticing with this flash
is you can see the shadow behind me, like you can see my shadow, and I think that's also what makes a really good flash photo, whereas if you have like a proper flash, or you do it in a quote unquote more like better way or more technical way, you don't get the shadow. That's the whole point of minimizing it. But I think it is the shadow that gives you that flash effect, so you know that it was taken with flash. That's just my own personal, like, this was taken with the Cybershot camera. Like, come on. So cute. Who is this adorable little beast? It's me. Da, 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 da. So again, the vibe for the shoot was 70s inspired, flash lighting, orange was the color, joyful was the overall vibe. I think too, that was difficult for me with this shoot, was like joyful. I don't know why, maybe I wasn't feeling super joyful today, but I was like, I don't want to smile for every photo. Not that joyful has to be smiling, but it's usually, you know, when you think of joy, you think of happy, happy, exciting, da 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 da. And I was really frustrated putting this together, so I think my joy left a long time ago. But it came back once I started shooting with the Cybershot. I think there's footage of me being super jazzed. Ah, so this is when I was playing with, like, motion blur with the flash. And even though my eye was half closed, this was the vibe I was going for. Kind of like party mode, energy. Yeah, super excites, which clearly I am. Blurred photos, playful. That, to me, signifies kind of joy, so to speak. So, yeesh. Oh, I want to get my full thingy in there. Come on. Oh, I think I got glitter in my eye. But already I'm like, yeah, I'm just in love with these photos, actually. These are so good. Da, 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 da. That looks a little too sexual for my taste. This one I like. Either way, what I learned today was to make sure you're using your equipment more than once every year so your batteries don't corrode the inside of it. That's just a fun little tidbit for y'all. And to keep going, like, just if, when one thing doesn't work, try something else. When that thing doesn't work, try something else. There's no right or wrong way. This is why I love, love, love self-portraits, because there is no right or wrong way. There really is just doing whatever comes to you and seeing what happens. And I ended up really actually loving a lot of these photos, especially this one. Let's turn this around. Oh, yeah, there she is. All right, maybe we'll keep this one for a little bit just because it's funny. But yeah, and so that's why self-portraits are a really great opportunity. Now, I know a lot of times people are like, oh, I just get so frustrated. Yeah, so did I, but that's the point. I would rather get frustrated working with myself and in the privacy of my own, you know, space or home or wherever you're shooting, than with a client. Like, I don't want a client to have to, you know, feel all the things that I definitely felt today. I just, yeah. So self-portraits are a great way to start exploring different ways to do things. And who knows, you might learn something, or you'll have fun with yourself. At the very least, you'll just make a mess and have some glittery oranges to hang out with after you're done. Yeah, so, all right, you get the point here. Obviously, at the end, I'm going to show you a slideshow. of the photos as they turn out, so you can take a peek at those. But if you like this type of content, of course, please let me know in the comment section below if you want to participate in helping me decide what I'm going to create for the next one. Make sure you're following me on Instagram, which is at Terry Hofford. And if you want to learn how to do your own self-portraits, in the description is my selfie 101 guide to getting started with self-portraits. It is really just about the technical and a bit of the creative on how I set things up and how I get going with my self-portraits. So yeah, self-portraits literally changed my life, and I believe they can change yours as well. If nothing else, they're connecting you and I right now, and that's pretty freaking cool. So that is it for now, my friends. Enjoy the rest of the images on the slideshow, and thanks for watching. You know I appreciate you. Like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!